You've got the final frantic hours of campaigning in the race to the White House. Donald Trump is right now speaking at a rally in the key state of Pennsylvania. Let's just take a quick listen.
So the biggest in the history of our country, whether it be 4 years, 8 years, or in one case more, shut down your economy, close down manufacturing, send your jobs overseas, destroy our suburbs, and he will destroy our suburbs. So I say to the women of the suburbs, love me, women of the suburbs, love me.
You know, it doesn't matter at what point you listen in to his press conference, it's always something interesting he's saying. And Miranda, you're writing in today's Telegraph. I tell you what, you're talking about Joe Biden and you don't miss, do you? You've called him the worst candidate in history. But seriously, what makes him worse than Donald Trump?
Well, Donald Trump won an election. He won the nomination fair and square for the Republican Party. You can't say the same about Joe Biden. It's really extraordinary that the oldest candidate ever, he'll be 78 in a week, is you know, heading the Democrat ticket, someone who's got obvious cognitive decline, who has stayed in his basement for most of the campaign, and who, now that he's probably busier out on the campaign trail than he has been the entire year, is really very tired and low energy, slurring his words, etc. And what a contrast to President Trump, who's out there doing 14 rallies in the last 3 days of this election. He did five yesterday. He went from snowing Michigan, absolutely freezing cold, just above freezing, 20,000 people at the rally, to, you know, warm Florida. He had, in Michigan on Saturday, he had 57,000 people at his rally. In Arizona, you've got people in these truck rallies, these car rallies for Trump. They call them Trump trains, going for, you know, kilometres. You have people in Pennsylvania waiting in line for 12 hours with the line snaking for a mile. You know, there is a lot of enthusiasm, and certainly the optics show you that in these battleground states, Joe Biden is not getting the enthusiasm that Donald Trump is. And also in terms of early voting, you're seeing that Biden's early lead in that, because, of course, the Democrats have made a big deal about, you know, early voting, pre-polling, mail-in voting because of COVID, whereas Republicans are less paranoid about COVID and they're more inclined to come out on election day and vote in person. But Joe Biden's early vote on those mail-in ballots and early in-person voting is shrinking by the day. His lead from the beginning is shrinking. So it's not good omens for him. Obviously, the national vote, the Democrats have got locked up. But I just do not understand, when they had a slew of really pretty impressive candidates in the primaries, why they rigged the nomination process to install Joe Biden. I understand they were trying to stop the very radical Bernie Sanders, but surely winning an election is better than not.
Well, look, I tell you what, there have been some cringe-worthy moments from Biden there, but, Bill, we've just heard Miranda thinks Joe's lost the plot. I mean, you once said that Donald Trump is barking mad. Do you still stand by that? And what a choice, hey?
What a choice in America. All I said is some of Trump's views were incredibly extreme, and I haven't changed my mind on some of his views. I mean, Miranda's analysis of Joe Biden is very interesting, and she's there and can see some of, you know, she's on the ground. But if you close your eyes, let's not forget about the last 4 years under President Trump. Australia will work with whoever America elects, but I think a lot of Australians want to see a return to some sort of sensible, you know, non-dramatic stuff happening in the White House. I mean, I have a friend who works in the Steelworkers Union in America, and I said to him, what's life like in America under Trump? And he said, every day it's like sucking on a fire hose. You know, it's just, you know, let's just have a bit of normal again and a bit of decency again. Mm. But it's going to be up to the Americans. It's their decision. Mm. But, you know, when we talk about Biden being a bad candidate, there's a lot of people in America and friends of America right around the world, including myself, who feel that some of the current president's comments and actions have been really quite off the spectrum.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, though, the US has never been so divided. You've got COVID raging out of control, plenty of people out of work. I'm not actually sure who'd want the job to be president. But we've run out of time, guys. All will be revealed in the next 24 hours or so. Thanks for joining us this morning.